good morning. So assalamu alaikum and a pleasant morning to all of you. So today is the great task for us. In fact, every class which I understand, I will come with a very great immersion to give you and provide you the greatest knowledge on the traditional medicine. To understand about the pathology of the disease, that particular moment, the textbook has given the great explanation in order to understand the depth of knowledge about the disease. We all know today there are the numerous diagnostic tools which is existing today in the market and also which is existing across the globe by doing the investigation on the laboratories, which is expensive. But here what we are going to see, so that diagnosis is the very super simple, at the same time it is inexpensive, and it is the non-invasive method of diagnosis. Across the globe, when we look at about the various system of the medicine, various system of the methodology of the treatments, all the close to the 200 different therapies, more than 10 different types of the system of medicine, when we understand there are only the few pulse diagnostic tools or the few pulses they normally see. When we look at about the traditional medicine, about the Malay traditional medicine, Tibetan traditional medicine, Indian traditional medicine, Australian traditional medicine, African traditional medicine, Japanese traditional medicine, American traditional medicine, and acupuncture and traditional Chinese medicine. In fact, this amazing, when we look at about the, see about the pulses, but normally when we look at about the pulse, there are only the quality and depth and force and rhythm, tension and force, normally we look into the pulses. But whereas in acupuncture, we definitely see there are the 12 different kinds of the pulses in normally we see on the arteries. Our 12 internal Jing Lu connectivity are meridians. Those meridians are internal organs. If there is a malfunction, there is a disease, there is a pathological effect is affected to that particular organ, that is reflecting on the radial artery in the different positions. But in single artery, where we can able to see and identify pathogenic factors and a pathological defect, with the topic now is to identify the patterns only through the radial artery. I told you there is a non-invasive method of diagnosis, is the tongue diagnosis. In the similar way, now you are using, when we do have the pulse diagnosis, is very super simple, at the same time having the great difficulty to analyze the patient. But no doubt, if you take it, this is the simple, then it is definitely it is simple. Then you understand it is complicated, definitely it is complicated. But due to that reason, the pulses and impulses, there is a book, and also there are the many authors has written the books in the name of the pulse diagnosis. Even the classic of difficulties due to that situation, this has been explained that in the various conditions how we can able to identify. There are the certain loopholes. If there is a great difficulty, there is a certain pathways which we call as a subtle pathways to identify the diseases. We all know there is auscultation, palpation, percussion, interrogation. These are the different methods of analysis. But the topmost analysis is, but in generally, when we look at about the Ayurveda, there is the three different pulses which we call as a cobra pulse, the another pulse called as a Menduka pulse, the third pulse called as a Swan pulse. Right, analyze and understand, because of the right side they see to the female pulses, left side they see the male pulses in Ayurveda. If we look at about the traditional Chinese medicine, right hand is belongs to the yin nature, whereas in left hand belongs to the yang nature, that is male. Right? So in this way now the curiosity to identify, because why I love to identify the diseases by the pulse, because when we study about the various medicines, Of course, there is a Yunani system of medicine, Ayurveda medicine, Indian traditional medicine, Greek medicine, the most of the Tibetan medicine. Traditional medicines are using the pulse diagnosis for the most of the times. But this Western diagnosis, of course, this off late, we got it around 2 centuries. And whereas in this is originating from the thousands of years ago, but no doubt in 1564 it is through the talking diagnosis, through the smelling diagnosis, through the interrogation diagnosis. If the patient is complaining, the disease, dis-ease, that is the, of course it is the illness. When the patient is complaining that I am good, quite enough, then you understand that patient itself is the evidence for the recovery. Patient itself is the evidence I am good internally. No doubt today there is a trend called as a, when there is a illness happened to our body, again we go to the doctors. We need to find out from the doctor whether I am right or wrong. I am okay or my still illness is existing within me or not. The people, doctor says, then you feel that internally good. But however, in the most of the times in the ancient system, and the people feel that I am good enough within, I have the enough energy, that's a quite good, that is the evidence for the, that you are, the recovery period has been happened to you, right? But today when we look at about the investigation, thousands of rupees, it is totally expensive. But here is a super simple way which we need to identify and understand, but how the body is situated in our body, how the internal organs are located in the body, in the similar way the organs also located on the radial artery. The whole body divided into 3 segments. The first segment to be called as a heaven, the second segment to be called as a person or human, the third segment to be known as a earth. That's heaven is known as a upper geo, the person or human to be known as a middle geo, the earth to be known as a lower geo. Geo denotes here is the cavities or the junctions. There is the upper junction, middle junction, lower junction. The whole body can be divided into 3 parts or 3 segments, the above the diaphragm to the top of the head to be called as a heaven or to be known as a upper geo. From the diaphragm to the navel to be called as a middle geo. From the navel to the lower part of the foot region, that to be known as a lower geo. When we look at about the internal organs, what are the organs are located on the chest cavity? So similar way, you need to incorporate it on the 3 different positions. When we understand about the pulse diagnosis, it's in the super simple way. Try to understand, when you lift the hand in the upward direction, right? So what are the organs are located on the first region? Now we understand there are the 3 segments I told you, 1, 2, 3 segments on the radial artery. How to identify this conditions? Especially there are the 3 places, even for the children is different from the adults. The location in between the each segment to be called as a 0.6 tune is the first segment to be called as a distal, you know, segment, which we call as a, where the LU9 Thayuan point is located. The second segment to be called as a Kuan pulse. That pulse to be called as a styloid pulse, or we known as a the middle pulse. So that pulse is located on the styloid process. That pulse diameter will be 0.6 chun or 0.6 inch. When we look at about the proximal pulse or the topmost, you know, the which we call as a, there are the 3 names for the pulse. One pulse to be called as a chun pulse is the first pulse. Second pulse to be known as a kuan pulse is the middle pulse. The third pulse to be called as a sho pulse, or the pronunciation is chi, chi. That pronunciation to be noted, that sh pulse. Or the, there are the other 3 different names for these pulses. The one pulse is the first pulse to be called as a polycarp pulse, the second pulse to be called as a Klusel pulse, the third pulse to be called as a pedal pulse. So these are the three different pulse positions which is existing on the radial arteries. Now the whole body is divided into symmetrical right side and left side. When we look at about the right hand, there are the three segments and the same way in the left side as well. When we understand about the first segment to be known as a upper geo, that to be called as a head and lungs and heart. The whole organs are above the diaphragm. What are the organs are located? The brain is located, heart and lungs is located. When you understand the upper geo, there are the two segments, that upper two segments that point to be called as a distal pulse. The first pulse to be called as a distal pulse. So this distal pulse are the upper geo, that indicating that there are the above the diaphragm, there are the topmost two organs are located. That organs called as a, on the right side the lungs are located, on the left side the cardiac system, that heart is located. When you lift the hand, there is the first segment to be called as a upper geo. Now the middle geo come down on the, which we call as a clusal pulse, or which we call as a middle pulse. So those particularly, that particular location you can find out. There are the two abdominal organs, the right side to be called as a spleen, whereas in left side to be called as a liver. Here is liver and pancreas, and then spleen, both are connected to the right side, whereas in on the left side the liver is connected. Anatomically the liver is located on the right side, but most of the times there are the numerous physiologies there which is connected to the left side also, the liver. When you come to the topmost Schie pulse, or which we call as a pedal pulse, or the third segment to be called as a lower geo, that to be known as a, one is the right side is the kidney, whereas in left side also kidney. The kidney can be divided into two, kidney in, kidney yang. Right side is the kidney yang, left side is the kidney in. But as per the Professor Park Javu, he said that right side, that to be called as a pericardium, that denotes for the brain. Whereas in left side is the kidney in, that is the root of the kidney, or the original of the kidney is located on the left side of the pulse. When we look at about the yang organs, as according to the traditional acupuncture, the lungs is connected to the large intestine. When you look at about the surface, there are the two kinds of the pulses normally we see on the hand. So there are the three pulses mostly. The topmost pulse to be called as a Fu Mai, that indicates that is a superficial pulse. When we look at about the middle pulse, that pulse to be called as a middle pulse. When we look at about the deeper level, that pulse to be called as a deep pulse, or the Chinese name to be called as a Cheng Mai. So now we are identifying the all the yang organs are connected on the surface level, whereas in yin organs are connected to the deeper level. Surface level, superior level, all the yang, that's called as a Fu Visera, is connected to the surface level, where the deeper storage organs to be continuously functioning organs to be known as a storage or solid organ, which is connected to the deeper level, that to be called as a In Visera or the Zhang Visera. When we understand the first segment to be called as a Fu Visera, that is the lungs is connected here, at the same time large intestine is connected here. Whereas in this side heart is connected, that heart is the small intestine, is Fu Visera, is connected in the first pulse, the deeper pulse is the cardiac system. Why is it so? Large intestines and small intestine is connected to the middle geo and lower geo. But as per the acupuncture, The young meridian organs called as a large intestine and then a small intestine called as a teno-intestinal or the cross-intestinal herbs are located on the, when we look at about the meridians are existing on the upper extremities, not on the middle or lower extremities. Where is the origin of the Yang Ming meridian? From the index finger, whereas in the origin of the Tino intestinal meridian is starting from the pinky finger, that is ascending on the upper direction, that is located on the upper extremities, not on the lower extremities. Why is it so? When we look at about the young meridians, lungs and the large intestine and the small intestine, origins from the finger and terminated on the Alanasi and terminated on the facial region. The energy starts from here, ends here. The starts small intestine energy ends on the in front of the ear. When we look at about the interior energy pathways, that is communicating to the pertaining organ interiorly. So this is based on the traditional acupuncture. When we look at about the herbal acupuncturist or the herbalist, they feel that they understand because of the herbal to be known as a traditional Chinese herbal. Even today, each and every country, they do have the herbal medicine, natural medicine, right? So they incorporated in order to treat the people. When we understand about the herbalist, they believe that intestines are located on the lower jaw, not on the upper jaw. Even we wanted to integrate it in acupuncture as well. So that means that particular large intestine is located on the topmost is the lower portion of the pulse, which we called as the Qi pulse. Where the pericardium is located, there the Yang meridian, Yang Fu Viscera, which we called as a large intestine also. No doubt there is a triple warmer is located on that particular region, but however the triple caloreal also located on that, and then large intestine also located on the third pulse. When we look at about the left side, which we call as a Tino intestinal or the small intestinal meridian or the intestinal organ is located on the left side, where the kidney in is located, where the kidney in that urinary bladder also located, which we call as a para orb of the uterus. What are those? When we look at about the fallopian tubes, when we look at about the uterus, ovaries, right? When we look at about the male, which we call as a gonads, also located on that particular region. Both the sides, you understand, this is the third pulse to be called as a pedal pulse. So that pulse is pericardium, right? Triple warmer and a large intestine as well. Please add up one more point on that particular region. The brain also affected through that pulse. If the brain is good function, then pericardium pulse is very feasible and it looks very amazing. The pulse will be the normal. When disease appears in the body, this pulse in normally you can't see that. When any one internal organ is affected, that particular region get impacted. That means it doesn't feel that pulse on that particular region. How amazing this is. But in fact, now we wanted to see their clinical symptoms and signs about the patient, and without only the giving the hand itself, that's quite enough in order to understand about their pathology. How really I feel it is very, very super power in acupuncture, where we analyze the patient on their own way. If you diagnose it properly, then you understand that patient feels that, yes, he treat also us. The psychology, try to understand about the patient, that's very, very crucial. With all the analytical data, sometimes you understand, because what I mean to say, even yesterday I have seen most probably 30 patients at last night. But all the 30 patients, I never applied 2 needles to the patient. Because I know I am teaching today for you as a pulse diagnosis. This you are learning, not the clinical or shotgun acupuncture. You are learning today is the classical acupuncture. What does it mean? What are the major difference about it? when you understand about the pulse pathology, then definitely is the one prick is quite enough to treat the patient. When I understand about the, in 1978, Dr. Siddiq Jamal and Fazlur Rahman, who are the medical doctors who treated on that particular movement, they studied acupuncture, then they treated by acupuncture by using only one or two needles most probably. They just apply the one prick, or they just apply the maybe, you know, one touch. Sometimes they are the, you know, topmost connectivity to Almighty God to heal the patient. So only they identify where the disease is existing, where is the origin to cause the disease, only one prick. Normally I used to apply in 2016-17-18. I just started pricking one needle. Then I wanted to do the lot of invention in acupuncture. For that basis, I selected number of the points these days in order to, you know, imagine, and also something I need to prove to all of you, that how does it work with the neural segmental pathways in acupuncture. At the same time, when we study about the Panchamahabhuta or the five element theory concept, which already you know what are the concept of the five elements theory, what is the Shang cycle, what is the production creative cycle, what is the subjugation cycle, what is the destructive cycle, what is the anti-creative cycle, what is the anti-destructive cycle. If we keep it that in our mind, so this also helpful to treat the patient by successfully using the perhaps is one needle or two needles. If you ask me a question, if there is a multiple organs are affected, how do you believe that there is the only one? There is a concept, there is a philosophy. We have to study about the philosophical aspect of the acupuncture, not the theoretical application to acupuncture. For that concept, if you identify which element is affected, that particular element you are activating by using the single needle. If there is a, for instance, there is a only one pulse is deficiency, that pulse to be called as a lung pulse is deficiency, then you want it to activate even the horary point also quite enough, that point to be known as a in-house point. That's called as a chincho LU8. As a tonification or sedation, you just apply the needle on that particular region, that also quite enough to treat for the pulmonary system. But this faith and the trust and the quality and theoretical aspect hold in the subject, and people faith on you, the trust on you, it is very crucial. When there is a pancreas is malfunction, treat by using the single point, that point to be called as a inpi, that is a spleen 1, or you can select the point to be known as a thaipi, that is a spleen 3. On the right side you select for spleen 3, that is definitely can be useful to treat for the diabetes mellitus. So here is identify the diseases through the pulse. Inference diagnosis or the talking diagnosis is different here, but you understand this patient is telling you, but you can take it that, but at the same time you need not to listen. Most of the times my way of thinking and treatment to the patient, sometimes I listen, because my name itself made that Sami. Sami means listen, that I understand I need to listen. I take all the concept of the patient, but when I diagnose the patient only through the pulse diagnosis, most of the times I select the point based on that particular condition. You never know, thousands of diseases are existing in the medical dictionary, but all the diseases comes under the five Panchamahabhutas or the five elements theory. When we look at about the only one particular organ, that having the hundreds of diseases under that one particular organ categories. So therefore, we don't know what could be the reason to cause that, but you understand what kind of the pulse is signifying and showing to the patient. And that time, what the Almighty God is giving the sense to you, that is the recovery to the patient. With good heart, with the purified heart, purified thought and a spiritual way, you wanted to treat the people in the holistic way, not the acupuncture treat for the physically, acupuncture treat for the emotionally, mentally, physically, socially as well. We have to take it in that way, right? So therefore, whenever we do have the dilemma, see, now the people says, I need the instant recovery. Even patient feels sometimes instant recovery. Sometimes patient feel is the later period recovery. You understand the monthly or, you know, weekly ones or bi-weekly or the later fortnightly or monthly also can be treatable. If you done one tonification, have you done one sedation, that also most of the times is quite enough to treat the patient. If you diagnose it precisely. But sometimes, today is the trend of the patient, they need a recovery very immediately. Patients comes the span of getting the problem for the last couple of years, they do require the recovery very instantly. The patients having the patientless within them. They give the time to us. Recovery period, it takes time within that, because of the today you are getting the disease. That disease is not happening today. You understand, this is my key point to you. When the problem is coming to you, for example, is a diabetes mellitus or there is a hypertension, there is a problem, anything related to the super simple fever. That also the problem is not coming today. That has been originated around years ago or the months ago. Then now it is pop-upping, reflecting on the surface of the body to show the sign and symptoms. To get rid of that from the internally, definitely, brothers and sisters, it takes some time to get the recovery. That recovery to be taken place to the patient, that's your and my duty to make them to understand properly so that they can be calmly take the treatment for the span of 3 months, for the span of 6 months. The pain is not unpleasantable phenomena, but pain is make it that friendly to you. It gives the small indication to you. There is some problem is there within you that is required for the recovery. No doubt there is a chronic pain is there, or the no submerged pain is there, or constantly and continuously there is a pain is there. Of course, nobody can explain the pain. The pain is only cannot explain, but that can be feel the people who are sufferer. But there is a very acute pain or maybe dull and mild pain that giving some alarm and indication to you that somewhere here is a mistake and try to correct it within you. That means you have to take care of yourself. Somehow, when we look at about the various points or the various locations, you understand today we're going to see about the practical section, where the particularly points and where the particularly pulses are located, what are the different qualities of the pulses are located. But the various authors has written there are the 32 different qualities of the pulses are existing, there are the 28 different qualities of the pulses are existing, there are the 17 different qualities of the pulses are existing. Some authors believe it is the 16 different types, and most of the times is the conclusive way we wanted to think about this. The most of the 32 different categories are very, very great difficulty to analyze and understand. The authors who has written the various books on the pulses and various books on the impulses, themselves they are in the dilemma, and they could not able to see one kind of the pulse in the whole age of that particular, you know, around God has written 70 years age for them, and they could not able to see that one pulse. So in that way, the pulse is 32 different qualities. In my whole age, if I practice for the span of 40, 50, 60 years, even despite of that, sometimes I can't see some kind of the pulse. Then why do they return that kind of the pulse in the book? But here, of course there is a terminal cases, of course there is a certain cases or that, you know, diseases, that particular moment that pop up certain pulses. So in that case, even I am not perfect on 32, even I am not perfect on the 28, even I am not totally perfect on 17 also. Then what I am explaining you, how I am explaining you. But here there is a subtle ways to understand. Why I wanted to take my head on behalf of that pulses, but it is that there are the short roots are existing through that analyze and understand. Even that gives the pleasantable happiness to treat the patient. Why I wanted to, you know, scrutinize in the deeper level to the pulses. But of course, there are the minimum the six kind of the pulses at least we wanted to know among them. So that I wanted to bring down only the three kind of the pulses. You understand, that's really quite enough in the, you know, in the beginning level. the people who are doing the masters, the people who are doing the dissertation. For them it is required to do the dissertation. I have the desire that we wanted to do PhD in pulse analysis and the pulse diagnosis and impulses. Minimum 3 years we do the expenditure for the pulse diagnosis to go to the various places in the state and then nationally and internationally. We need to go to the tribes to see the pulse diagnosis. We need to go and see in the rural and urban areas as well. The pulses, how they take the food, based on the food constitution, the pulse also get changes. Based on the emotional conditions, pulse also get changes. When after food there is a changes, before food there is a changes. What is the ideal time to see the pulse diagnosis? In generally in the early morning is always is good, before breakfast or the after evacuation, after the elimination of the urine, after elimination of the defecation is always is good. After the first urination, the inner organs is not yet started, young organs are not yet started. That time analyze the pulses is most of the times is really good. Even I do suggest you in future, when you will going to practice, most of the times you can analyze the patient in the morning itself. If possible, you just do it. And immediately after the breakfast can be treatable, or the before breakfast also can be treatable. Right?